Anderson Cooper is keeping them honest. AC 360, CNN weeknights, 8 Eastern.
Never seen that. Second
Romeo, roger, Captain. We good to go.
The hunt is on.
We're going to do a routine safety check
for a dolphin killer.
The dolphin case is in the back of your mind.
Right. I mean, we're not going to just come out and ask him, you know, are you shooting dolphins?
Your permission to come on board? Or
we're going to actually look and see if there's any evidence as far as firearms and such forth like that. Firearms. Guns.
Officer Leo DeGeorge and a Mississippi Marine Patrol unit are searching any boat they can find, trying to unravel the mysterious and disturbing case of murdered dolphins washing up along the Gulf Coast.
So I'm going to go down below and take a look, see what I can find there.
There's a growing sense of urgency. Between January and November of this year, 7 slain dolphins had been found. But in the last 2 weeks, 2 more dolphins and a part of a third washed ashore. Some have been shot, some mutilated, with tails and a jaw cut off. Only the head of one dolphin was recently found on a beach. Many pictures, too gruesome to show.
So the one thing it all has in common is that all these dolphins have turned up along these little barrier islands along the Gulf Coast.
That's correct.
Moby Salangi is the lead biologist at the Institute for Marine Mammal Studies in Gulfport, Mississippi. He's analyzed the corpses of all the dolphins for federal investigators at NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. There now could be as many as 10 murdered dolphins, the majority discovered in the last 2 months.
What do you take away from all that?
Well, it looks like somebody is deranged. It's really senseless. It's repugnant. It's illegal. We don't understand what type of person would do such a cruel act.
When we first started asking questions about the dead dolphins a few weeks ago, we asked federal investigators if they thought this could be the work of a dolphin serial killer or killers. They told us then that that was not one of their theories. But since then, 3 more dolphins have washed ashore, and those federal investigators now say they can't comment on an active criminal investigation.
You've seen these animals up close. Were you able to see anything that kind of leads you to believe that it might have been the work of one person?
Well, it's really hard for us to do because all we can do as scientists is report the fact. It's the investigative agencies and people who are trained to determine what type of connections and what type of profile a person has.
Federal investigators told us a few weeks ago they think the murders are not connected. But along this coastline today, many people are wondering if there's a deranged dolphin serial killer or killers hunting these beloved creatures. On patrol, wild dolphins bob up and down all around us. The mysterious string of dolphin killings is something these officers have never seen.
What's your biggest fear about the way all of this is playing out?
The biggest fear, more of them. And why would somebody do this? I don't know how they're getting a thrill out of this.
And the search intensifies for a predator lurking around these waters. Ed Lavandera, CNN, on the Mississippi Sound.